newera ukireherwa ni rangi wa crown. Crown paint, if you like it, crown it.
Thank you muno mwereru wa Dristons TV kukunyitoke ni ororigi notoria wa kuriru okiru ni Mr. Morris Maina mudhenya wanga tuto ni ati tafarira ya training irakuro iki ni kirira mudhenya wa mudhe ni kukuro kimunyitoke ni idhi ni wagi suje kia mwisho nikitha akuro wagi tuwira fata wagi dhomo gekiri ni uriku hariwe mwere lili ni urate idhikana tafarira ya kukuro idhi training inu wama udumari ya mwode ureka letono ya ku up your game kana ku up your service then you wa uruti wa wira irateithia Kenya na jereha natia ni kurikana then you wa tafarira ya bere wa mwabiririo ni tukuriru tugithoma ati hindi ya ukuheana motungata then you wa wafishi kana hindi ya ugutura wita mu Kenya uheanaga motungata then you wa community then you wa thibitari thirikari kuwira-ini gwaku mucii we ukindungata ona nini ndiragutungata uguo ni ukorwo akiri haha nigetha tukinikiririe training itu tondu nake na njira iria yagiriire.
Even if you don't know where you are going, and you even ask the security guard, where is this door? Where is this thing? He will make sure that you get help. Even if he's not the one who is going to offer it, but he will make you sure that the desk he'll take you, you'll be able to get help from there. Is that the way we are doing here? All our soldiers, when you tell them, I want to go to the just get in and you. Each and every company has their own mission, isn't it? But one Changi, everybody is married to their culture, okay? You can see many partners, 229 companies are not small. Many missions, each and this company is being governed by their own mission, isn't it? But there is only one Changi, okay? And during your free time, that is number one. In service, where everybody else, and remember, it's not only, this data is not only for airlines, it's for all the companies. It's not only for airlines. Another company, another place which has a very good service is one you can go and Google for yourself, you see, what is in there. That's another, is a hotel, also in Singapore known as Marina Bay Sands. Marina Bay Sands is built on land reclaimed from the ocean. And where do they have good service? And there are so many other companies. If you want to borrow my copy of Uplifting Service, that book, or from Janet, you can have. You see many companies. I just mentioned two. Others, there are companies even like Dr. Madao in India, there are two companies which lie within number 10 as far as UT something. There are several companies which hold that. But why do those companies have good service? Because they don't have a culture like that. Is that a confused culture? Well, maybe this is Mr. Rakesh, the CEO wants to go that way, or his miner is thinking this is the best way. Somebody else is thinking this, that's a confused culture. You can only offer good service when all of us are aligned to one direction. Okay? When all of us are aligned to one direction, the thinking of the CEO at the board, that's where everybody is aligned. So one. Another part of why we are here is to try and align everyone into that. We have an aligned culture. And how do we do that? So there are so many things of doing that. Like in this education we are in here, we have already set procedures. One of them is service leadership. The directors actually is the directors, Mr. Rakesh Patrick Mwati, and he said himself, who went in the world to check who are the people who can offer good service? And in that, we are trained 10 people to become your trainers, okay? So the leadership has to be there. Because even if we come with good ideas and the leadership are not for it, but here our umbrella is the leadership of this company, the directorship of this company. They are the ones, one of their duty is to make sure that Crown offers the best service in this region, okay? Coupled with that, We have actionable service education. That's why we are here, isn't it? And in there are so many things, yeah? Some of them, they are happening behind the scene. They are happening behind the scene, we shall see that. What is the difference between education and training? Because we agree those two words, they don't mean the same. Dr. Madal, maybe you can answer this. Training and education, what are they?
According to me, education is something that actually you try to gather knowledge, okay, from somebody, okay, which you do not have within you, but you have statements, well-defined actually directions, and also the methodologies by which actually you can work towards that altogether actually gives you the.
Correct. Well, see, training, you are impacting somebody with knowledge, isn't it? And that's what not what I'm doing here, isn't it? You're training, you are impacting somebody with a skill. This is how I want you to do this. Don't think on your own. Like those guys are being trained. But here we are giving you education because I want you to give you knowledge such that you can think on your own, isn't it? That's what I'm saying. Is this guy trained or educated? To fry this Airbus, is he educated or trained? Education, I know he's, but he's trained to do that, isn't he? He's trained to do that. This is, he went to somewhere to be impacted with knowledge to fry the Airbus, isn't he? It's not when he's in the air, 40,000 feet above the sea level, he wants to try his own style. Suppose I turn it this way. No, he has to. Isn't it? The other thing, he's also educated because for you to be trained to be a pilot, you must have a certain level of education, isn't it? What about a surgeon? To be able to perform the surgeon, is that a training or education in performing the surgeon? It's training, isn't it? Yeah, to be trained to be a surgeon, you must become a doctor first, isn't it? Up to that level, you don't know how to do a surgeon, isn't it? Then you are trained to be a surgeon, isn't it? Because we don't want a surgeon when he has opened your heart, and this is the time he's telling his other colleague, can we do this valve this way? I think I have a better style, isn't it? He has to follow the instructions. If that guy for start to follow his own things, you see where you run, isn't it? Okay? So, now, you remember this one I showed you? One of the things we are going to do so that we align to a good service culture is common service language. That's something which we'll do. Then there is something happen, engaging service mission. Already we have one, we have done that. Number three, service staff recruitment, new staff orientation. When we employ people here, are you looking for people who can get into your service or not? So that's something else which will be checked. Service communication, how do we communicate about service in this company? Service recognition and rewards, how do we recognize the people who have given good service and how do we reward them? Voice of the customer, how do we capture the voice? Don't write this one down, I'll tell you. Don't. Voice of the customer, how do we capture the voice of the customer, both internal and external? Service measures and metrics. When we say our service is good, which measures and metrics are we using? Which standards are we using? That's why you see, I was refraining to give you which is the best company here in Kenya. Because apart from gut feeling, which I can give you, which measures and metrics have they done to know that they are the best companies, isn't it?
All right. Giving your customers something they never expected to get. This kind of service is like a special gift. And when people get it, they like it and think, ooh, what a nice surprise. That's the key word at this level, surprising. When I fly into a major airport, I travel with 2 suitcases and a briefcase. The suitcases go in the back of the taxi, and I sit in the back seat. When we arrive, the taxi driver takes out my bags. And once in a while, the driver will say, come, let me help you. Picks up 1 or 2 of my suitcases and walks with me to the front door. In many places around the world, I don't expect to get that level of service. I don't even hope for it, because most of the time, I'd be disappointed. But when it happens, I say, ooh, what a nice surprise. This level of service is surprising. To say this, lift your hands up and say, surprising. Let's do it together. Ready? Surprising. One more time. Surprising. Yes. Here are some examples of surprising. The product comes with a fabulous video showing you how to set up the product quickly and then how to use it correctly. If you need more help, there's a 24-hour toll-free hotline with friendly people waiting and ready to help you. Delivery is available whenever you want it. The invoice comes with something special, an unexpected discount. That's delightful. That's surprising. Surprising service can happen inside your organization. You ask someone in another department for help. They answer your questions quickly, and then they come over to give you some extra information and personal assistance. You didn't ask for the extra help, but they realized you might need it. Their help is very useful. It makes your work a lot easier. Your colleague's extra effort was unexpected. That's terrific. That's special. That's surprising. Surprising service is something special. Even higher than surprising is astonishing, extraordinary, incredible. It is so good, I call it unbelievable. I once had a taxi driver. When I got into the taxi, it was spotless, perfectly clean. It even smelled nice. The driver said to me with a smile, good afternoon, sir. It is my pleasure to be your taxi driver. I thought, wow, am I lucky. And then the driver said, before we go, would you like to listen to some music? I said, sure. He asked, what kind of music would you like to listen to? So I asked him, well, what music have you got? The driver handed me an attractive card. On one side was a list of all the local radio stations and the type of music they played. Classical, country, jazz. On the other side was a list of music the taxi driver carried for his passengers' listening pleasure. So I made my choice, a little upbeat jazz. And then I sat back to enjoy this wonderful ride. At the end of my journey, I said to the taxi driver with a big smile and a big tip, you, sir, are unbelievable. This level of service is extraordinary. It's incredible. It's unbelievable. To do this, you've got to pump your fists in the air and say out loud, unbelievable. Ready? Let's do it together. Here we go. Unbelievable. One more time. Unbelievable. You got it. Here are some examples of unbelievable. the product, comes with a range of features way beyond what you ever imagined. Wow! The delivery team comes in, unpacks your product, sets it up, and then teaches you how to use it, all at no extra charge. Wow! The invoice, what invoice? This shipment is free. Wow! These experiences are astonishing. Service like this is legendary. People love it, and they tell other people. This extraordinary level of service can happen inside your organization. You ask someone in another department for help. They tell their colleagues, and their whole department goes to work on your request. They come up with great new ideas to make things easier for you and much better for everyone. Even more, they help you get the job done. That's incredible. That's right on top. That's unbelievable. Unbelievable is wow.
Wira ne wira ukireherwo ni rangi wa Crown. Crown Paints, if you like it, crown it.